Tonight, more than 100 people still do not have power in Kansas City.
Now, hundreds more are still waiting for city crews to clean up their area, especially in the Ruskin Heights neighborhood. Larry Seward shows us why it's taking so long.
Rattling generator is golden in Ruskin Heights.
I still don't have any power.
About 150 people in Kansas City do not have electricity 2 days after a microburst blew in.
What can you do but wait?
For Robert Bailey, damage appears overwhelming. Tree branches crushed his patio, punctured his roof, down power, phone, and cable lines. But he's not angry. He's firing up the grill, throwing a party. It's his daughter's birthday.
Birthday comes, you still got to celebrate, got to move on. So, you know, got a little grill, so you can, at least you can still cook, do something, got a generator, got some music, you know. So all you can do is make the best out of it.
For others, seeing the best through piles of debris lining their streets is difficult.
Here it is Tuesday afternoon, and they still haven't even picked up these small piles either.
Bob Ludlow is upset with Kansas City cleanup crews. Sunday, he saw crews with dump trucks push this fallen tree off the road, then leave it for days along with these piles in front of Ludlow's home.
Our first priorities are to clear the roads.
City crews working 12-hour shifts spent a day just clearing roads. This is day two of cleanup. There's a lot of debris in a lot of driveways, meaning homeowners need patience. For Christine Osborne, crews rewarded her patience by tearing up part of her front yard while clearing debris.
I'm not really worried about the damage.
Why not?
Because I can really take care of this. It's not too bad.
But for others, the wait is just beginning. Officials say it could take up to 10 days to clean up everything.
That was Larry Seward reporting. Now, Kansas City Power and Light tells us they expect to have customers powered restored sometime tonight.